Sassy, what are you doing here?
Well, I heard about the accident. I figured anyone knew anything, it'd be you. It's just so terrible. You know, you hear about stuff like this, but it's somewhere else and somewhere else. And I knew all those people this time.
Yeah.
B?
Back here, Carlo.
Carlo? The one that fucks with everyone he sees?
Yep, he's on the paper staff.
How do you put up with him?
I told him if he ever hit on me, I'd have him neutered.
Good job.
It works.
Where are you?
In the editing room.
I just heard some news in the office. One of the students is dead.
So what else did they say?
Nothing.
You're sure?
Positive. Look, can't we just do this some other time? I'm really in pain right now.
Maybe if you hadn't let Drake drive without a license, you might not be in pain right now.
Your compassion is really touching, you know.
What were you thinking? He's never even driven before.
He wants to learn. I was just trying to help.
He got in a 4-car crash. Great job.
Look, I don't need this right now. Just get the hell out.
I'm not leaving without word from my brother.
Look, it's my room. Go wait somewhere else.
You okay?
Yeah, a couple bumps and scratches, but I'm fine.
What about Jensen?
He's a little worse. Concussion, a couple broken fingers.
Did you talk to him?
They won't let me.
I'll see if I can check on him.
Luz? They think I did it. They think I caused the accident.
What? That's crazy. I was there. Kirby's car swerved right by us.
Kirby and Neo are both in a coma. They're not well, doing too well either.
Who else was in the car?
Joel.
What about him?
He doesn't remember anything.
Is that just temporary?
I don't know.
What about the others?
Well, they saw his headlights.
That leaves Jensen.
He was passed out drunk before the accident.
Okay, so we're back to me. But I saw what happened.
You let an underage driver drive your car.
I mean, Tripp's an eyewitness. His word has to count for something.
They'll just think that you're trying to defend me. Plus, Kirby's parents are well off. They're not about to let this slide.
We'll get through this, okay? Kirby will eventually come to you and tell what happened.
Well, there's something else.
What?
Jensen spilled some liquor on my shirt. The cops could smell it.
But you didn't drink any, right? I mean, they have to test you on that, and it'll prove that you did?
It was just a sip, I promise, okay?
Heidi, are you here?
Yeah. Oliver?
Oh my god, Jolie!
Yeah. Hey!
It's so good to see you!
I know! How are you?
I'm good, everything's back to normal.
I'm glad. I didn't know you were here, Oliver.
Yeah, I got back about a half an hour ago.
Wait.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, when I got out of the hospital, I made him promise me to come see me. Hope that wasn't selfish.
No, not at all. I just didn't know you two were in touch.
Off and on, but yeah, I gotta go. I'll call you later.
Are you still on for dinner?
Yeah, sure. See you later.
Bye.
Bye. So, tell me about summer camp.
Well, it was amazing. Oh my gosh, we did so much stuff.
Well, I appreciate you keeping me informed. Please let me know if there's anything we can do. Thank you.
You okay?
Personally, yeah, I'm fine, but...
The accident?
Yeah, it was bad.
Well, it could have been worse.
True. So have you moved into your dorm room?
Everything's unpacked.
I could have helped you with that.
Well, that would have defeated the purpose of us keeping our relationship a secret.
I don't understand. Exactly why do you want to keep it a secret?
It's bad enough being the new kid in school. It's worse being the principal's kid.
As long as you're not ashamed of me.
Never ashamed.
Okay. Well, since school hasn't officially started, how about you and I go to lunch?
I'm up for some food.
Well, since I have to be such a big secret, how about we go Dutch?
Dutch?
No! No!
fun. I wish I could have been there.
It was. Maybe next year?
Totally.
Seriously, though, how are you? What did the doctors say?
I'm fine, trust me. The doctors took care of me.
I'm sorry I didn't visit. I really wanted to, but...
It's okay. I mean, you had summer camp, and you know how hospitals are with visitors. Besides, I got to see Carpenter and Oliver a lot. It's good.
Oliver is in my brother?
Yeah. I mean, he helped me a lot, and he sent me really funny cards. And besides, I just don't know what I would have done without him this summer.
So, how was the conservatory?
It was everything I dreamed of.
That's good. I want to hear more about it.
And I will tell you. But first...
Hey, Dizzy!
Hey.
So, how's Callie?
The hospital says she was fine, but her father wants to take her to a regular doctor just to make sure.
Well, we have good news. Sorry it took so long, but we wanted to make sure. You're perfectly fine.
Good.
And so is your baby.
What?
Your baby.
So, he was there at the cemetery when you were hit.
Yeah, he's the one that ran over me. Said it was a total accident. See, he lost concentration when he saw Jared there.
Then that proves your son is alive. Did he say where he is?
Safe. He's out there living his life, but he thinks I'm dead. Isolated, living in the country. He's exiled himself. Blames himself for everything.
So he just tells you this? No deals? No conditions?
No. Because he knew it was going to hurt me.
Over there. I could help you there if you like.
Oh, no, I can,
No trouble. You must be new. I've been here about a year. It's a pretty big campus, but you'll get used to it fast enough. If you'd like, I could show you around. There's a student union, but, and then there's some restaurants in town that are pretty cool. I could take you to one if you like. I do have my own car.
Carla!
Yo.
What did I say about bothering the new girl?
I'm not bothering. I'm helping.
Are you Paige? I'm Noah. We're gonna be roommates.
Nice to meet you.
I was just trying to help.
You wanna help? Good. Go to the parking lot and get the rest of your things.
But we were planning to go out later.
Plans have changed.
But I wanted...
Carlo, you're gonna have all year to pester this poor girl. Why do you want her to hate you all at once?
Good point.
Just bring her things to the lobby. Thanks.
This is definitely not what I had in mind.
He was just trying to help.
I don't know, as is every female student on the campus. Carlo is harmless, but to save yourself a lot of trouble, you might want to just ignore him now.
That seems cruel.
I know, but to be nice to him is like wearing a sign that says, "I'm waiting for you, Carlo." So, sometimes it's just better to swat the bug before it comes around.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You have me worried, you sure?
Yeah, it's been a long day.
Well, looks like it.
Are you new?
No, well, no, actually. I'm here with my brother. He's visiting a friend, you could say.
That really sucks that you don't go here, I mean.
I'm really hungry, actually. I was gonna go to the student union.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to keep you.
No, I was actually wondering, would you want to come with me?
Sure.
Excellent. I'm Carly.
Sure.
Nice to meet you.
gonna do? I mean, I just don't know what I'd do if Drake had to go to jail.
It's not gonna come to that.
How do you know?
Because I have faith.
I appreciate it.
Now, we are going to be as calm and positive as possible. The worst has happened. What more could go on?
You really think the worst has happened?
Absolutely.
Hi, I'm Gigi. I'm your new sweet man next door. I don't have a key yet, so I hope you don't mind if I just store my things in here for a bit. Whew, I didn't think I was ever gonna get here, but then this boy offered to bring all my things over, and then he offered to walk me over to the Union to get me a Coke. I couldn't say no to that, could I? Cute top, can I borrow it?
Who is this boy?
Carlos something? He sounds European. Ah, who cares? As long as he's a boy and straight, unattached, I'm happy. Well, I gotta go. I'll probably catch your names later. Bye-bye.
The worst thing, right?
Mm-hmm. Hey.
Hey.
How are you doing?
I'm hurting. Mom was supposed to go get medicine, but it's been over an hour.
It could be taking her so long.
I'm sure she's going as fast as she can. Can I get you anything?
No. No. I'm sorry. I just need to get the medicine. Hey, I'll be fine.
Well, let's talk. Get your mind off the pain.
Fine. Whatever.
So what happens?
That is supposed to get my mind off of the pain.
I just want to know what happened. You haven't really said anything.
It's because I don't want to talk about it.
Sorry.
No, wait. Stay. I'm sorry.
You told the police you didn't remember anything. Is that true?
Just little bits and pieces. Neil was in the backseat, heard Kirby was driving way too fast, and I told him to slow down, but he didn't.
Did you see what caused the accident?
No. I was turning around taking care of Neil. It'd been a fight.
So you were turned around when the accident happened?
Yeah.
How'd you get bruises all over your chest and on your back?
I was in the backseat. Yeah, it's starting to come back.
So, what side were you on?
I don't remember. Look, what are you trying to do to me? I'm hurting and I don't feel good.
I'm back.
What took you so long?
Hey, you're lucky I got back with anything at all. Hey, no, sit down. Look, I talked to the doctor. I told him that last night that those medicines he gave you were not working. And he said that the injuries that you sustained didn't warrant those strong meds. He wanted to see you again next week. But I told him that if he would just give me a few, that we would see if it would help.
Five pills? You only got me five pills?
Well, honey. You know, maybe you're not gonna need them at all.
You're right.
I went to check on the boys.
Kirby's dead. I know, I heard on the radio.
But y'all Wolf.
It's okay, I can take it. I told him to slow down, but.
No, son, it's not Kirby. He'll be fine. He's in a coma, but after the hemorrhaging goes down, he'll be okay.
What?
It's true. He's gonna be all right.
But I touched him. I saw him. He was dead.
No, Kirby's gonna be all right. It's Neil that's dead.
Oh, hi. I'm surprised to see you here.
Oh, hey. Just getting some work to take home. Then I'm gonna vegetate on the couch for a week. Doctor's orders.
Good for you. Hey, how's your daughter?
She's good. You know, bruises here and there, but I think about what could have happened.
And then, as we talked, he just
kissed me, or I kissed him, I don't know, but I do know there was a kiss. I was confused. Maybe he was just trying to comfort me. I don't know. Maybe he was making fun of me. No. Surely not after what he did. Does that mean that he has feelings for me? I mean, why didn't he say anything? I mean, I've had feelings for him for 2 years, and I've kept quiet. It has to mean something, doesn't it? Anyway, I decided to ask him. That was the mature thing to do, besides I knew I'd go crazy if I didn't. So, I went down to his dormitory, and I was told that he had went out of town. I mean, no word, no nothing. I know we're not in a relationship, but he could have at least told me he was going out of town. Especially after that kiss. Unless I initiated the kiss. That could have scared him off. So what do I do? Could I have actually scared him off? Please, just tell me, what do I do?
Stop writing so many romance novels. Quit whining. $2, please.
$2?
Inflation.
You know, Lucy only charged a quarter in the comic strip.
Lucy is a cartoon figure. Get a real life.
Ready to go?
Sure. Oh, if you really like this guy, you might want to do something about that hair.
What?
And a push-up bra might not hurt.
I'm offended by a 10-year-old.
Hey, Libby, who are you talking to?
No one.
Look, I'm sorry about what happened.
I mean, well, Neil Gottman was coming to me, so.
Excuse me?
You're talking about the fight between Neil and Dean, right?
Libby, you better sit down.
How you feeling?
I'm doing better. Why are you here?
You got a phone call last night saying there was an accident and I should come down here.
Who told you to do that?
I don't really know. Some girl said if I came down here I'd find my brother. But it's funny, I don't have a brother.
What's your name?
My name, Cord.
Hey man, you wanna play some sack?
Man, we gotta talk about something, dude.
So do you remember me at all?
Nah, I remember a little. Bits and pieces. I remember there being kids and then not.
Do you know you were adopted?
Oh yeah, I know I was adopted. My parents are my adoptive parents, you know. They're very honest with me. They even let me keep my name Cord.
Did they ever tell you about our mother?
Just that she left me on a park bench.
Us. She left us.
And our brother.
Decker.
Decker, he just left you here.
It's a long story.
Well, I've got time.
So what have you heard?
I haven't heard anything, you know? That's why I'm so upset. Kirby's still in a coma and he can't verify the story. Besides, why would he want to verify the story, you know? Yes, officer, I'm the one that caused the accident that killed Neil and injured 7 others.
Because it's the truth.
You know, I've got to find a way to keep Drake out of trouble.
Well, maybe I can help.
How?
I just might surprise you.
Oh, there you are. I was wondering where you were. Are you eavesdropping on us?
Me eavesdropping?
No, how could you ever think that? It's pretty easy.
Just knock next time.
Sure, no problem. I just wanted to see if you wanted to go to dinner, but I can see you're busy.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow.
Great. Sorry about your brother causing the accident. That hasn't been proven yet. Oh, good. Well, that's not going to affect your scholarship, is it?
What do you mean?
Well, because the original winner was from Germany, and he had to pass it on, and you came in second place. So? I just didn't think the school would give out a scholarship to someone whose brother caused the death of a fellow student. Bye!
Hey, Callie, listen. You're gonna have to make a decision.
I know, I'm
so upset about Thomasina, I didn't even pay attention to my body. I didn't even think that I could have been...
pregnant?
Ugh, don't even say the word.
I mean, you're gonna have to think about it sometime. Have you even thought about telling your father yet?
Yeah, but... I've disappointed him so much.
But this is way too serious.
I don't know, I just... I don't know what to do. Hey.
Hey, what's up?
How are you?
Not so good.
Still in lots of pain?
The doctor says it'll go away. He gave me some pills, but they really put me out.
As long as they do the trick.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Hey, I'm sorry about Neil.
Yeah, me too.
Supportive, and I just really feel like we've got connected, you know? Mm-hmm. Oh, crap. I forgot my purse. Give me a second, okay? I'm gonna go get it.
Okay.
Speaking of which, hey.
What are you doing?
Going to class.
I mean, what are you doing with Heidi?
What are you talking about? We're just friends.
No.
She and I are friends.
So you tell me she can't have more than one friend?
No, remember when I first pitched the idea to come here? You put up such a fit. Mom and Dad were gonna send me somewhere else. You hurt me, and you made me feel like dirt, and you humiliated me. All because you didn't want a tag-along sister.
All right, I was stupid.
Yes, but you dictated who my friends were, Oliver. You told me who I could and couldn't talk to, and now I have a friend. I have a best friend, Oliver, and you're ruining that for me.
Sorry, I didn't know how it made you feel.
Stay away from me and my friends.
You're serious?
Yes.
You've gotten really close. I don't want to hurt her.
So you're going to continue to hurt me?
No, honest, I just... Jolie, please.
Would it matter if I told you I loved her?
No.
Hey, thanks for waiting. Hey, are we still on for tonight?
Something came up.
Oh, maybe later?
Yeah.